Moncrief, thanks to yourlocal.ie, Ireland's fastest growing online directory. News Talk 106 to 108.
Today is the 40th anniversary of the Apollo moon landings, or the 40th anniversary of the biggest hoax in history, if you're fond of a conspiracy theory. Hoth-based artist Robert Shaw wants to pay tribute to it, but that took a while, and Robert is here to tell us that story. Afternoon, Robert.
Hiya, Sean.
You're a child of the 60s, you would remember a lot of these things.
Well, no, 64, so I was five when today's event happened, so I have vague memories of it. I have a twin brother, which is kind of key to the whole story, and he lives in New Zealand now, but in 1969, on this day, we were living in Waterford, and I can remember my dad getting us out of bed. I think it was about 10, about 20 past 10, doing my anorak research earlier on. 20 past 10 Irish time in the eve, at night. And I can vague memories of it, of the big event.
Of the scratchy pictures, really, which you can hardly make out what it was, really.
But I mean, you kind of fill your own memories in yourself, too, you know?
I think possibly people who can remember that, I grew up with this idea that, you know, at this stage of the game, we'd all be going on our holidays to the moon, flying around in jet cars. It just seemed like that was all going to happen.
Oh, but it was a different time, wasn't it? Everything it filtered through into total in modern culture, the whole idea of just space, the whole thing. But what I've done is the astronaut that struck me was Dr. Mitchell, Apollo 14. I remember I was trying to work out a few years ago. I remember sitting, and it turned out it was 1971, I was sitting on the footpath on the way to school in a winter's morning, looking up at the moon, waiting for a mate to go to school with. So myself and the twin brother were sitting there looking at the moon. And there was a mission, and it turned out, in hindsight, it was the Apollo 14. And my other brother, I suppose I was even at seven then, I was an anorak then, Stephen said, "I can see the men on the moon." And I said, "Stephen, don't be so ridiculous." And so the Apollo 14, anyway, was one of the other missions, because there were six in total, and obviously the one that got all the attention, which naturally would be the first one.
Of course,
they were equally brave
each
time. But
I think Edgar Mitchell, didn't he go twice? He walked on it once and no. All right, I had that wrong then.
No, he was with, he's the last surviving crew member. Stuart Roosa died about 6 years ago, and Alan Shepard as well. So there are 12 men walked on the moon, 9 are left alive, and most of them are moving into their 80s now. So it's kind of the end of an era in that sense.
And you wanted to make a painting and present it to Edgar Mitchell. Was there any particular reason why it was Edgar Mitchell?
I tell you why. It wasn't that I was sort of just stalking him for years or anything. He was back to my twin brother. I've got a nephew. He's got a son down in New Zealand, and I've only seen him once. And I wanted to send him something spacey because he's getting to that age.
Right. Yeah.
So I searched around the different websites, but I found on Dr. Mitchell's website you can get a signed autograph picture. So I thought it'd be cool to get him to send it, which I did.
Yeah.
And when I was doing sort of online transaction thing, I wasn't sure if this went through. So I said, okay, how do I find it? So I emailed. And as I was emailing, I said, do you know what? Let's just have a go here. There was a painting, just totally on impulse, a painting I'd painted last year as part of an exhibition. And it was in a gallery in Galway at the time. And I said, you know, it's the Earthwave painting. I'm just going to say, with very clean and open motives, say, I have such respect for the bravery of, I'd like to make a presentation of a painting to Dr. Mitchell. Oh, and by the way, did the transaction go through? And I thought nothing of it. And next thing, I got an email back, which I was surprised. And his executive assistant said, yes, Dr. Mitchell finds that painting breathtaking, which, whoa.
And you'd sent him a picture of
I'd sent the image, a JPEG image of it. And
he'd already heard you. That would have been really cool.
That was it, yeah. I've known your work for years. She said, well, how do you intend to present it? I was like, I'll fly over next flight, you know. But as it turned out, it opened a long sort of gentle courtship and a dialogue that spanned over a good few months. the big issue actually was, you know, to gain their trust, because there's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of fruitcakes, and I'm proud to say I'm one of them, but out there to, that, you know, as it turned out at the end, I remember it, I've spoken to him three times now, and it turns out that they get a lot of people looking for endorsements, and this, and there's three or four manuscripts and books come in every week. So it was very gentle courtship. And as I say, the response, DHL stepped in, which were wonderful to actually ship the painting. They built a big crate. And that process, so he received it on St. Patrick's Day last. And ever since then, I've just been in touch. And I, when I rang the first time, I was wanted to talk to Cathy, his PA, and he answered the phone. And I kind of went, is Cathy there? And it was a bit of that. And in fact, the three times I spoke to him, I was looking for Cathy to speak to. And as it turned out then, every time I spoke to him, the last time I spoke to him, I really had a good chat with him. And because I had put a lot of thought into a letter I'd written to him, just to outline where I'm coming from with it and why, and the respect and the whole sense of what his... he had an epiphany, as a lot of them did. Hard-nosed, hard-boiled test pilots flying back from the moon all had some kind of emotional, spiritual, whatever you want to call it, change in them. And he specifically went back and set up a foundation. At the start, it was kind of flaky and fluffy, but it's very, very science-based now, the IONS Foundation. And to speak to him on the phone, he's very... very low-key. The first time I rang, it was like, this is Dr. Mitchell speaking, and I said, this is Robert Shaw. I sent the painting. Oh, Robert, I can't actually talk to you right now. I'm in a conference call. And I kind of went, can't talk to me. Can't you know the hassle we had? But the last time I spoke to him, he was much lighter, because he's obviously more familiar. I'm not as...
I'm not a nutcase.
Nutcase of sorts, but I'm not as...
not the sort he tried to avoid. Really. Yeah, exactly. The ones that were going, go on, admit it. The whole thing was done in the studio.
But he was very gracious, and he was very... he understood my motives and where...
And the painting you sent him, Earthwave, just describe that.
It was a painting, as I said, I painted last year. A lot of the work I do, I kind of like to have a bit more interest. I booby-trapped them. And not all the paint, you know, in the sense that you look at it and then a year later you're going to go, oh, gee, I didn't see that in it before, you know. And the studio's in Howth. I see it's all inspired by the Leinster coastline and seascapes and life and death at sea and life cycles and all that. And this one was based on the Celtic idea of going through to the other side, the ninth wave, whereby the Celts thought on the ninth wave you pass over and so on. But this one I noticed that it looked like you're in Earth's orbit. So when I was sending the initial email, I knew straight away, this is the painting. So I got it back from the gallery and set about getting it out to them. But all in all, it's been a very exciting thing. I mean, at the start of it, the motives weren't, they were purely private, but having spoken to him last week, you know, it's a lot more. It's moved on from that now. So he's given me his blessing in saying.
Oh, well,
that was
nice. And the thing you read consistently about the people who've been to the moon, it's not so much being on the moon. It's looking back at the Earth and just seeing what a small, vulnerable little ball it is in the middle of nowhere.
I mean, it must be extraordinary to. I mean, but the thing is, he himself was there on the moon for 33 hours, and he could not remember when he came back. He couldn't remember being on the moon. He had to do hypnosis to actually go and
wow,
which was interesting, you know. But apparently, you know, from on the moon, because the light's all different angles, there's a famous photograph that's of him reading a map.
Right, yes.
And they were literally lost. Himself and Al Shepard were trying to get to this cone crater, a ridge at the Frau Mauro Ridge, and they got lost because their sense of perception of distance apparently goes gaga. You don't know if you're coming or going. So something that's close is actually much further away. And his frustration, and both their frustration, they spent hours and hours and hours trying to get to this ridge, which was crucial in terms of the mission. They needed to get some geological research done to find out how old the Earth was. That was the purpose. And they got lost.
That's extraordinary. That's extraordinary. Yeah. I'm just looking at that picture now. Yeah, and there he is reading a map.
That's all.
Robert, thanks very much for coming in to talk to us. That was a fascinating story. Don't you have a website? Do you want to plug your website?
Yeah, it's robertshaw.ie, and there's some more information, and there's some links there to if you want to find out more about the missions or NASA and so on. And Earthwave is on it as well.
Fantastic stuff. Okay.
Thanks a million, Sean.
Thanks, Robert. That was Robert Shaw there. We'll take a break after this in search of Doggerland.
Moncrief. Thanks to yourlocal.ie, Ireland's fastest growing online directory.